Everyone, today we the students of class 12 are here to present a PowerPoint presentation on the effects of colonization on the Indian languages. India, also known as the Sone Ki Chidiya or the Golden Bird, has a huge cultural history.
Many of the colonial powers tried to attack India. Some of these were English East India Company, Dutch, French, Portuguese and Dano-Norwegian.
The vast culture also brings a vast number of languages that are spoken in India.
Languages in India belongs to a large family of languages, which include Indo-Aryan and Dravidian languages.
India has 780 number of languages, which makes it the second largest country in terms of number of languages.
Languages in India have a long history. The languages in India belong to a large family, which is Indo-Aryan and Dravidian, which are majorly spoken in India. Other languages include Austroasiatic and Sino-Tibetan.
The Dravidian family includes has over 70 number of languages, and Tamil and Telugu are the majorly spoken ones. The Indo-Aryan languages represent the easternmost branch of the Indo-European family and has a huge history.
Each of these Indo-Aryan languages are inspired from other Indian languages. For example, Hindustani was influenced by the Arabic and Sanskritic languages, while Bangla retained its Sanskritic roots.
India takes pride in its linguistic diversity and has taken steps to preserve it. India doesn't recognize any language as its national language.
According to the statistics, 1,652 languages are spoken in India, while the constitution gives 22 languages as official language.
Linguistic diversity shows that there was an interlinking of languages. Sadly, the linguistic myth that once defined the culture and the tradition of the country is now shattered. The impact was not only economic in terms of that, but language was affected as well. This shows the postcard in which the Lord Macaulay addresses the British Parliament and says that a country like India can only be colonized when they break the very backbone of its society, that is their culture and traditional roots.
The British has influenced the British came here as traders and businessmen, but they start influencing Indian political and economic status.
Education was introduced to make a class of educated Indians helping the British in administration.
As in 1844, English was recognized as the official language. It was declared that the people having the knowledge of English language would be preferred more for the public employment. The idea was to make a race that would be Indian in blood, but English by taste.
The theories of philosophers like John Locke instilled the notions of democracy and freedom in the Indian minds and prompted them for a change. The diverse regions speaking different languages were now communicated with help of English, and in this way English was a blessing in disguise. Although English had a huge impact on the Indian languages, but Indian languages as well impacted a number of words in English, like Matru became mother and Bhratru became brother in English.
The current scenario is that India now proudly claims to be the world's second largest English-speaking country, just after the US.
Although language is only a mode of communication for the people, but people today in India, specifically Indians, however, are putting English language as a measure of their intellect. In the end, it's fair to say that although Indian languages had a huge setback, but it led to the development and modernization of India as a society and united people under one